3, 2, 1, liftoff. It's the Randy Kagan Show with Randy Kagan and me. I'm Lance Solo.
Welcome to the show. Thank you for listening. I appreciate it. Tell your friends. Make some friends. I'm surrounded by friends. That's why I do this gig. And Lance. If you're wondering why we haven't done more, it's because I don't have to. So,
stuff going on. Things happening.
Yeah, I got off the road with Craig. We took the fastest passenger jet in the world, the Citation 10. Zoomy. You know, he won't talk about it. He wants people to think that he's taking a covered wagon or he's walking. I'm on my way. Creakety. But I have been given carte blanche to scream it at the top of my lungs.
Do they serve that to you guys on the thing? Or
what?
Carte blanche.
Oh, boy. No, but I do get Skittles because a while back, they don't call them, when you're in flying private, they don't call them stewardesses. They call them sky angels. And these aren't Aunt B-looking chicks.
Nice.
I'm saying these. Remember when the girls used to be hot when you, in the day when you were flying? You remember. It was like Orville Wilbur.
Yeah, back when I was like 6.
In my day. They were cute. Now all the hot ones went to private. And they're not stewardesses. And they're not gay dudes. They're sky angels. And if you go, hey, where are the Skittles? Oh, I'm sorry. Next day, boom, Skittles.
Wow.
It's that kind of world I live in. You know, I have vomited in some of the nicest planes. No, but here's one of the sky angels said to me, the only time I ever did hurl in a G450. Take that, Puff Daddy. She's knocking on the door. She says, I swear to God, she goes, don't mess up my bathroom. I'm bringing up a pancreas. I got like photo albums from 8th grade coming out of my gut.
She was like a Sky Rickles.
I called her a Sky Devil.
I like it.
But Sky Rickles is good.
Yeah.
Anyway, you plan on puking all night?
Hey.
Hey.
Randy's in the bathroom going,
It's like, hey, I'm fame adjacent. She's like, yeah, I read the contract. You're not the one I got to schmooze.
Yeah, clean up in there.
Yeah, do you mind while you're vomiting? Here's a squeegee.
Here's a little soap and some
Babo. We made out afterwards.
Nice.
No, Craig and I.
Yuck.
Craig and I. Crookity and I.
Vomit.
Anyway, mouth. So there's a new show, a tour, and as usual, Craig has some kind of retarded way of being a genius. He's got a midget, a brother, a Jew, 2 puppets, and a Scottish guy, and that's the tour.
And where do you fit in?
Do squeak. I'm the midget black guy, obviously.
I thought.
I like your little chuckle. When Lance has a special laugh when he laughs at his own jokes.
I seldom do because I'm seldom funny.
True. I didn't even know you were that often. But it was interesting because I have to get in a little case. It's hard to explain. Craig is doing my intro. Before I had to do my own. Now he's got this cool song and you hear his voice.
Oh,
and
nice.
He's got a couple of wacky antics. So in a way, Craig's opening for me.
That's right. You're opening. He's opening for you. Then you're opening for him to
and then,
open.
And then
for
there's
you
a midget
again.
And a black guy.
And a midget.
And then Craig told me that the word midget is as bad as calling a black guy the N-word, so I started calling the midget the N-word, and it seemed to get settled.
This week on the Randy Kagan Show, Randy interviews English comedy sensation Russell Spam. His agent finally calls. Femi Minotta will be calling in. A small interview with Khloe Kardashian. She'll be talking about her scent and her new perfume. Our first international call from Russia with love. And of course, Randy's own cougar, Lancey Fetterman, will be calling in. The Randy Kagan Show is brought to you by...
Finally, a new hip replacement that's hipper than you are. The new Turbo Hip Thruster. Now, just hit the green button and the Hip Thruster does everything that you can't do anymore. Here's what some of our customers have to say about the Hip Thruster.
I love it. I can watch Madlock, and just one push of the button, I can also satisfy my lady. Ow! Thank you, Hip Buster.
That's right, the Hip Buster's just one button away. I'm so lucky to have with us one of the most powerful English comedians from over the Atlantic. We're so lucky that this kidney pie tsunami has come to visit America.
Powerful. I like that word, Randy.
Russell. I mean, Russell Ham, ladies and gentlemen.
It reminds me of your thighs, Randy. Powerful.
That's so funny. Everything you say is so English.
Thanks, Randy. How about this for you? Kidney pie. London Bridge.
So you guys invented comedy. Who were some of your influences?
Well, you see, Randy, I went to Eddie Izzard University of Cross-Dressing, or something like to call it UC Homo.
Wait, is it because UC Homos?
No, it's because everything's funnier with f***ing lipstick in a f***ing ring.
Yeah, well, it's hard to argue that.
Well, would
that.
It be a Cockney ring? Yeah, see, that's funny, Randy.
Oh, my God, it's so... I can't believe how you're... English, you guys are so much funnier than...
I came to America so I could be unfunny in two countries, and I can be less than humorous on both sides of the Atlantic.
Now, is it true that you have more teeth than the average comedian, that's why you're able to be so much more funny?
I have more teeth in my mouth than all of London.
Hey, aren't you dating a famous singer?
You know the song, I Kissed a Girl and I Liked It?
Yeah.
I was the girl, Randy. I gotta get out of here, Randy. Me... Eddie Izzard, Billy Connolly, and some other English are getting together to do a bisexual version of the Full Monty.
Hello, are you there? Our international caller, I think it says Bruchki? Bruchki?
Hello. Is this the Kagan Show?
Yeah, is this Bruchki?
It's Ivan.
Oh, sorry, Ivan. Hey, Ivan, yeah. How did you find out about the Randy Kagan Show?
Well, you know, we just got this new thing called internet in my village. We decided we were going to go look for something that sounded like crap. So we were just, you know... looking around, trying to find something, and we found this guy, you know, talking about stuff that, you know, some people really don't care about, you know. His hamster. Nobody cares about your hamster, my friend.
So, why did you call me if I disgust you? I mean, what?
Well, I'm just doing what Americans do. Call and complain about things because they think that's going to get stuff done.
I'm sorry. So, Ivan, the reception's amazing. What are you talking on?
I'm talking on iPotato. It's actually, cousin of Sputnik.
It's amazing how many different things you guys can do with a potato. How many things can you do with a potato?
You can get mail-order potatoes now. You can do whatever you want with them. Whip them, poke them with fork, you know, even for right price, you might even be able to scallop them. You know, if you're going to try to pleasure a Russian woman, you need a very big potato.
So are you planning to come to America?
Well, yes, I have heard that it is a lot cheaper to live in America. Plus, there's more tail to chase rather than chasing actual goat tail.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Hey, maybe we can do like an exchange program where I go to your country and you stay here and I do your job, whatever the hell it is.
Well, you're going to love it.
What do you do in your village?
Are we able to actually say over this fancy...
No, I'll turn the mic off. This is just between you and me.
Okay, so what I do is I go out and I get to,
If you're planning on moving away from your iPod, do not. Randy will be back shortly.
Anyways, that's the reason I don't get the male Brazilian cut any longer. What?
Famey Minotta's on line one.
Wait a minute. My agent is on line one? Famey! Is that really you?
Hey, hello, Ricky. I have a gig for you.
It's Famey. This is my agent. For people who don't know, it's Famey Minotta, my agent. And no, I don't go by Ricky anymore, Famey. I go by Randy now.
Oh, whatever, Randy.
What's the gig?
I have a gig for you overseas, Randy, entertaining the troops.
You're kidding me? I can't even... Kimberly, my agent got me a gig entertaining the troops. This is like... We should put in some fake applause. Can we do that somewhere? So, we're Italy, Germany. I love to travel. Guam?
I've got two words for you, Randy. Afghanistan.
All right. I don't mind entertaining the troops. It's the troops, right?
Oh, well, yes and no.
What the hell does that mean?
Well, it's for the troops. It's just not our troops.
Wait a minute. Are you listening to him? You want me to entertain the enemy?
Oh, Randy. Enemy is such an unpleasant word. I like the term, paycheck, or perhaps another term, money. Your act is very much like a smart bomb, Randy.
Oh, thanks, Famie. That's nice of you to say.
A smart bomb sans the word smart.
Wait.
I've got to go, Randy. I've got Skippy from Family Ties. You know Mark Price.
No, I understand. But Famie, can we... I'll take the gig. I don't even... Kimberly, can you see if you can get him back on the line? This episode of the Randy Kagan Show, sponsored by Skype. Here, reception is... name of the... Skype is... sausage... it never... Skype! You get your money's worth...
The Randy Kagan Show. The best cubicle comedy on the internet. Hey, look out, here comes the boss.
Be funny.
First black kid I ever saw, he'll definitely never play basketball.
I asked you, huh? 40 million stars. I get a little kid out here, doesn't know what time it is, and brings me out, and you're standing here with the band with the same cockamamie music. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Try to learn it. The president's here. It's a big shot for me. Last night we had Bush. Well, I'll tell you this. He was great. Did you see him and the wife after the show? He was in the lobby going, nobody knows me. I gave him a cookie. He went away. He didn't know what time it was. I'll be with you in a minute. I'll tell you this.
Did you see some of his movies? Stiffs.
Good evening, Mr. President. Nice to see you, sir. And your lovely wife, Nancy. It's a big treat for me to fly all the way from California to be here for this kind of money. See, I still got the tuxedo marked down. Anyway, you need 38 tags to get in here. 38 tags. The Secret Service is walking around the lobby. Did you see the president? Anybody see the president? Where's the president? The president's with Nancy in the hall going, let's try it one more time. Remember when you were governor and you used to walk over to my table? Now you're big and you're getting on my nerves. I'll tell you this. Is he laughing? If you see Marines coming towards me, go into glory, glory, hallelujah, and shoot Webster. Anyway, nice to see you, Secretary Schultz. What are you doing in town? Anyway, Secretary of State's here, and Billy Graham, nice to see you, sir. This hand is bothering me. Anyway, I could have been a pitcher if I've talked to this guy. It's great, though. I make fun of the president. Why not? I make fun of everybody in the world. That's America. Laughing, Charlton Heston. I'm a friend. It's over. I'll tell you this. If you were Moses, I was a Mau Mau fighter pilot. Elizabeth Taylor was backstage in a Cleopatra outfit killing snakes. I'll tell you this. And Tom Selleck was under the shower going, look at this, the water runs up. I'll tell you this. Is this too fast, Ronnie? Anyway, he's sitting there looking at the program going, where does he say he makes fun of me? Where does it say that? It's only a joke, Mrs. Reagan. They got real guns. I spoke to the hospital, Nelson. You died about an hour ago. I say this, though. Is this too fast, Secretary Schultz?
I'm very excited about our next guest. She's a regular on the show. She's actually on location at a project she's working on called the CBC The Cougar Boot Camp. I guess I understand. I'm reading the press release. It's to help like-minded women to achieve their goals and dreams. Lancey, are you there?
Well, hello to you, Randy, and you don't need to diminish a proud and, might I say, legal in most states lifestyle.
Okay, I'm sorry. Let's get to the point. What type of things can people expect from the CBC?
What was that again, Randy? It's cool. Hey, grab him, would you please?
Where are you? What are you doing right now?
Well, we're working on some tactical fence climbing and wire cutting.
What does that have to do with the CBC?
Well, you see, most high school and middle school athletic areas are always fenced, some kind of cyclone fencing, and, well, you know those damn Amber Alerts. At CBC, we like to turn obstacles into opportunities.
Now, what kind of other activities do you have at this CBC Cougar Boot Camp?
A new activity called Hide the Game Boy. There's a brand new Game Boy hidden somewhere on my body. Whoever finds it first wins. And, of course, we have Survivor Weekend. We were given a canteen of water and two young boys. We had to light a fire using pubes and a magnifying glass. For obvious reasons, I had to use my own. Then I asked the boys if they could rub their sticks together. It doesn't start a fire, but who really cares?
So, Lancey, what other courses do you offer at CBC?
Well, Boypedia, information on understanding today's male youth. How old are you, by the way, Randy?
I'm like in my 40s.
Wow, that's so close to death, Randy.
Well, sorry, Lancey.
We have classes and seminars called Buying Beer for Boys, and a discussion on roofies called In Case of Emergency.
Do you have anything at the Cougar Boot Camp that's physically challenging?
Well, we have the hop, skip, and jump on the young boy. And at the end of boot camp, the women go through an obstacle course.
Oh, cool, like running through tires and climbing over walls?
No, Randy. Real-life obstacles, like parents, teachers, those pesky law enforcement officials, child protective services. Hey, grab him, Edith. Oh, God, Randy, I have to go. One of the young boys has climbed over the fence, and he's running free. Oh, God, grab him, please. I've got to go.
This is the Randy Kagan Show, sponsored by Potatoes. First, second, and always fifth love.
And now it's time for Creepy, but Not Illegal.
Hey, you ever play with a ball? Hey, you ever hike the Grand Canyon? Hey, you ever go down on an escalator? Hey, you guys ever read?
That was another episode of Creepy, but Not Illegal.
You know, I just read this. I just read this that the CIA is using overseas resources to fight terrorism. We are now outsourcing spies.
Who is it?
It is me. My name is Skippy. I'm totally from America, Des Moines, Iowa.
I don't want any.
No. Have you seen any type of activity that would you consider suspicious?
No. I don't know. I don't want any. Who are you?
Excuse me, sir. We are going to door-to-door as American people who are not spies.
Who is it?
It is me, someone from America who is here to ask you a question, but not about anything covert.
There is nobody. No one is home.
Love the Yankees. I enjoy hot dogs. And I know the Star-Spangled Banner.
Dave's not here.
Do you mind not doing anything terroristic? Please stop doing anything anti-American and watch Family Guy.
In Russia, we go skiing uphill. Americans are gravity babies.
It's Randy's Rant.
So I was kind of torn when Kobe said that comment about gay people. I know hate language is dangerous. People worship Kobe. Anger towards someone for something that doesn't affect your life is not acceptable. You're not supposed to yell stuff at people for things they can't change. Like, hey, midget, get taller. Hey, douche, stop being a bag. You know, things you're born with genetically. But to me, gay people are funny. I wouldn't punch a clown. I wouldn't punch a gay dude. There are heterosexuals who do unnatural acts in bed. Let's punch them. I mean, what are we supposed to do? Have an outline of acceptable sexual activities, a chart with graphics. Have you looked at the available products for heterosexuals lately? Three-headed, heated, dishwasher-safe, energy-efficient, things you stick in things. Where does it say in the Bible, thou shalt not bring produce to bed?
Hey, you guys seen Jeff? This is Jeff Foxworthy. I got a new book called You Know You've Been Exposed to Radiation If. Here it goes. You know you've been exposed to radiation if your testicles glow brighter than your nightlight. You may have come into contact with radiation if your rice forms a union and refuses to come out of the bowl. We're going to have a new friend of mine on. Her name's Meredith, and she couldn't make it in, and here's why.
Hey, Randy, I just got your message. I could have done it at 4:30, but I took a Klonopin, and I smoked a joint and a half. And I'm sounding like such a drug addict right now, but actually, I guess I gotta accept it. But, you know, I got my mom and her boyfriend coming into town for the next 2 days. And so I'm totally available. Please, I would love to do this. It sounds like a lot of fun. And I talked to Lance about, like, the suicide hotline and all that stuff. Boy, that would be easy to do. But anyway, so please, any day next week, if you're not traveling or, you know, working, then please just, I want to do it. It's just I'm drugged now. I can't drive. And I'm for the next 2.5 days. Anyway, so please call me again, and I'll be there. I know where you live. Okay, I'll talk to you later. Bye, Randy. Thank you for calling and thinking of me. I think that's great. Bye.
The Randy Kagan Show is brought to you by...
Here's what some of our customers are saying about the new Turbo Hip Thruster. Now, with just one push of a button, I can be 21 again. And again and again and... What was I saying?
Yes. Like always, the boss always leaving rather than staying here for job.
Lucky I even give you a job, you immigrant.
Hey, that's fine. I'd rather be doing this than sitting at home petting goat. He gets old after a while.
Goats do?
Sometime.